And then after that, you went on to do some incredible interviews on the television. What was Bill Cosby like?
Oh, God, such a jerk. I can't even speak of it.
Seriously?
Oh, God, yeah.
Because he comes across as lovely man, and his comedy is
no.
so
bitter,
good.
Bitter, angry, loathsome.
Because he's... That's because he feels he isn't given his due.
I don't know. You know, this is 50 years ago. Maybe he's evolved. Maybe he's dead. I don't know.
Some of us do. You said that Madonna took against you.
It was a terrible interview.
So do you know what it was about you that
she
took against?
Yeah, I was very nervous. And if you're nervous, you throw it onto them. And they can either react by getting aggressive, and then it makes me more aggressive. And it was a really ugly interview. Ugly, ugly.
How aggressive?
Let's not talk about it. I was offered to do Yes or Arafat, and I was offered to do Gaddafi, and the BBC said no. Said, no, we want you to do a game show. And that's when I walked.
No,
I said, I'm out of here.
Of course, these days, if you wanted to do that and the BBC said no, you could stick it on the internet. There'd be somewhere for it to go.
Yeah, see, but the internet wasn't cooking then.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. John Simpson fixed it up. And they said, no, do a game show. No, that's when I hit the wall.
Wow.
Yeah.
And back then, were you ever given stipulations what you couldn't ask before the interviews, or was that your...
We were doing 5 days, so they could say, I don't want that in. That was fine. We took it out.
And you didn't have handlers hovering or anything like that?
At the end, I did, and that's why I said stop. Because in the beginning, I'd stay overnight, you know, we'd hang. And then when the Gestapo moved in, I said, I can't do this anymore.
And that was your choice then?
Yeah.
So that must, because a lot of people don't get that luxury, television careers or media careers, they go on so long. And
no, I would have still been there, but then it started being F-list celebrities and G-list celebrities. And my face, you know, I'm not Graham Norton.
Yeah.
He really loves, he can gush with everybody. When I don't like somebody, it shows on my face. And so it was a nightmare.
Wow.
When I started interviewing people who I didn't respect.
And then you thought,
Yeah, that's it.
How concerned are you at this stage in your life about what other people think of you?
Oh, now it doesn't really matter anymore.
Seriously?
Well, look, I have something to focus on. Mm-hmm. And when you have something to focus on, everything else drops away.
So,
and I'm not at the mercy of them liking. I don't have to win a popularity contest anymore. Whereas when you're holding on to TV, you're dependent on your ratings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if the graph starts when you're a baby and you don't care what anybody thinks about you, you just want food and you want looking after, and it ends...
And then you jag up at 20.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So where does that graph peak for you then?
About caring?
Caring what people think
of
you.
Well, I'm back in the cot, you know, kind of letting the, you know, excretia go. And not caring.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah. Mentally, though.
Free-flowing mental excretia.
Yeah. Helpless.